This is 10 News, and more unemployment woes are on the way for Victoria. Education Department staff this afternoon were briefed about a restructure which could see the loss of nearly 1,000 jobs. 10's Sarah Arbo joins us live now. Sarah, what more can you tell us?
Well, I can tell you, Helen, that a number of employees were brought in for an Education Department mass meeting today to discuss this proposed restructure as part of the government's sustainability initiative. Now, there are 1,500 employees employed at the head office as well as regional offices at the Education Department. It's understood around 900 of them could possibly face job cuts. We're talking administration staff, not teachers, not frontline staff, nor share teachers. Now, of course, this is just the latest in lots of bad news Victorian workers have received. Earlier we heard from others who are preparing for unemployment.
4 years of hard work, all for nothing. David Eastham left in shock. He and more than 100 of his colleagues will be joining the unemployment queue.
Everyone was out of work. Some people as quick as October.
Altona North's Kerry Ingredients is the latest company to close its doors, jobs being sent offshore.
Love to have the Australian dream and have a house someday with a mortgage, a couple of kids. But right now, I think those chances are very limited.
When CMI shuts by month's end, Derrimut man Keith Thomas will also have nowhere to work.
I got two kids, and you know, they're just in school and things like that. So it's a matter of putting food on the table.
With so many Western Suburbs workers sacked, it's having a big local impact.
It's pretty bad. It's quieting down a lot since all the job losses. We've got only me and the boss, and that's it. We can't afford any other workers.
Yeah, this is the quietest we've ever been since we've been open, like in 1995 to now.
Every one of those people who was previously drawing a wage would have spent that money in cafes, restaurants, doing whatever. All that money starts to drain away from the local economy.
The opposition blames the government for about 1,200 jobs lost in the past 6 weeks.
And the real question today is how many jobs have to be lost before Ted Bayou starts doing his?
There's been an increase in people working in manufacturing since we took over as the government.
Sarah Arbo, 10 News.